And to my daughter, Betty Jokudu. This is your day today. And we must be glad in it. Amen? The message that I'm going to give to both of you, and then including the congregation, the people that will stand behind my son Angelo, who has taken courage to become a priest. I know that it's not a very easy task to become a priest, especially taking care of people. It's not easy task. So what I'm going to do is to read in the book of John 21, beginning from verse 15. If you have a Bible, just turn to me there. My heading says, Jesus reinstates Peter. Jesus reinstates Peter. And it reads, when they have eaten, they have finished eating, Jesus said to Simon Peter, Simon, son of John, do you truly love me more than this? Yes, Lord, he said. You know that I love you. Jesus said, feed my lambs. What did Jesus say? Feed my lambs. Again, Jesus said, Simon, son of John, do you truly love me? He answered, yes, Lord, you know that I love you. Jesus said, take care of my sheep. The third time, he said to him, Simon, son of John, do you love me? Peter was hurt because Jesus asked him the third time, do you love me? He said, Lord, you know all things. You know that I love you. Jesus said again, feed my sheep. Amen? So the task that my son Angelo has taken is not an easy one. That is why he needs reinstated. Because we are human. Even if we are ordained to do the work of God, it's not easy because the people that we work with is not easy to take care. That was why Jesus Christ, on his last days, he was telling Peter, the head of the disciples, asking him three questions. So my message to my son is that watch over the congregation. Listen to them. Smile with them. When there's need for cry, cry with them. Share every difficult situation that the congregation is doing. In that way, God will bless you in the ministry that you have taken. Because when we look at our community, the South Sudanese community here in this country, we have a lot